beginning stages of any piece of art is the spark of the idea, or concept of the piece we would like to create. So the first step for us is coming up with this idea that we would like to sculpt. So before I began this project, I went to the internet to compile a few images to help me come up with a character to sculpt. In this case, I landed on a hammerhead shark, which has an interesting shape, and of course, the famous hammer head. Now I wanted to focus on creating a character that was primarily humanoid, which would be a character that walks on two legs with two eyes and two arms. For the next image, I landed on a group of people cleaning up an oil spill. And with the combination of these images, I was able to finally come up with an idea for a character. I give you Shark Boy. Cleverly named, I know. So Shark Boy has been sighted walking the beaches by the locals, cleaning up oil spills and preserving the beaches at night. No one knows where he came from or when he was given the name Shark Boy. So now that we've had some fun discussing my character concept, throughout this series, you can follow along with me and sculpt this particular character, or come up with your own creative ideas and use the methods we will be applying to your very own character. Now, if you don't have a secondary monitor and you'd like to call upon some of your reference images or drawings, we have a quick option at our disposal. At the top of the ZBrush window, we have a slider called SeeThrough. By clicking and dragging this slider from 0 all the way to 100, we can adjust the ZBrush window transparency to see through, which is essentially looking at what is sitting behind ZBrush. Now, this will keep ZBrush the primary application in use and see through to whatever is sitting behind ZBrush itself. To set ZBrush back to normal, simply drag the see-through slider back to 0. Thanks for visiting ZClassroom. I'll see you in the next video.